Okay, we're going to Animal Ark in Columbus, Georgia, Muskogee County, to adopt an animal with the current name of Scruffy. The name will be most likely something different. See Animal Ark Rescue. Then we got a baby with us. She's going to meet her new brother. We welcome you all to watch us claim a new member of our family. It's a nice, it's a no-kill shelter, right?
Yes. Got her?
Yep. Hi. They're closed? Oh, they probably just didn't turn the thing around. Hey, would you take her? Come on, baby. I know you're here.
It's okay, sweetie.
She hears scary stuff.
Maybe she just wants to pee.
This is a really nice shelter. No kill. Yeah.
Okay.
Come on, baby. Some nice kibbies here. These two love each other. They were snuggling yesterday when they were here. Hi.
Hey, how y'all doing?
Good, how about you? Hi.
Yeah.
We're here to adopt Scruffy.
Okay. Well, we want our dog to meet him first.
We want our dog to meet him too.
Okay.
We're also broadcasting live on the internet.
Oh, no.
Oh, look at the sweetie Petey, sweetie Petey. Oh, you're so full of energy. Oh.
I love that they're in close. Oh, they want to see me.
This looks like Jazz when she was a little girl.
Hey,
good. We're broadcasting live.
Oh, there he is. Do you want to do it outside or do you want to do it in
here? Well, I think we want to meet in here.
Okay.
Good boy.
She's shy of people.
All right, what do we do now?
Well, we gotta let him in a little bit.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna take Scruffy out.
They're meeting for the first time. They're gonna be pack mates. And they. Scruffy doesn't realize it, but he really hit the lottery.
You know, Scruffy? No.
Yeah. Hey. You're a good boy, aren't you?
Scruffy and baby. She's not wagging.
She's scared because she's scared of people. That's why I think. She's like happy. She likes Scruffy.
She's fine.
She's fine. Yeah.
Here, you want to tell me?
Sure.
Come here, baby. Baby. Come here, baby. Good girl.
What'd she say?
She said something about him on TV.
Oh, what do you say?
Yeah, they like each other, I think. She looks happy. Are you happy, baby?
She wants to get out of here.
He looks happy. You smile.
So what do we got to do? We sent
I
in
filled
an application.
Out the application online yesterday.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. You got the. Who's doing
it? Just need to read and initial this and put in at least two or more numbers.
Okay.
That gives them the microchip.
Sure.
I'm not saying he's going to leave your yard because he's never jumped the fence on the
road.
Okay.
You never know. I don't even know if he could jump.
He doesn't look like he'd go anywhere. Are you putting there?
No, this was. They can't read it.
Okay.
Scruffy.
Do you know if his name
Scruffy's
was Scruffy before you guys got him?
Or did you guys name him? That's Baby. That's our dog. They're going to be pack mates. And he is a lucky dog. We're real good owners. He's been... Here's a little story about him. His owner died, and he was left behind at his house by the rest of the family in Harris County, Georgia. And he's been here at Animal Ark since February, 6 months. No, we're getting big ones.
No, that's the
main
one. I thought it was Mamie Cameron, but show me.
Okay.
He was... Since he was older, right, Harris County was going to put him down, and they called us and we pulled him.
Oh, goodness.
Because he had been abandoned.
in a yard up there.
So was he like tied up or something?
He was just, what I understood, that the owner died. And
but what happened is he was on a vacant property. I think that was fenced in. Mm-hmm. And that was like a whole big Facebook thing about it. People saying there's a dog on a vacant property. And they were constantly tagging animal control. And people were going to go there and take the dog, but they didn't. And then come to find out that the woman, I believe, either died or went to hospice, but she had family that lived next to the property that was feeding him, and he was sleeping on the porch. But due to public, you know, constant, I mean, just went on for days, for weeks. So then animal control went and got him, and after that, no one cared anymore. You know?
Yeah, and then
I followed up on it, and at the time he was very scared and skittish, so they were really not going to make him available for adoption, so we took him.
That one?
And been working with him ever since.
He's just sick.
But I mean, there were hundreds of people that were so concerned about this dog.
And then they just left him.
Then they just left him.
Well, they did it so we could get him.
There's a reason for everything.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And he's been here that long waiting for that people.
6 months.
Yeah. He's got such a great personality.
He does. But you know, I told you yesterday when he first got him, he was really scared and skittish. Mm-hmm. But I think he just didn't understand what was happening.
Yeah.
You know, as unfortunate as it was where he was at, I mean, that's all he knew.
Yeah.
And then they took him out of that and stuck him in a kennel, and he just didn't understand the world anymore.
Yeah.
He
just
But he learned our routine, and he's okay with, you know, he was okay with being here. Everybody mm-hmm. loved him. So he really came out of his shell.
We just love him.
But hello, beautiful.
She's scared of people that she doesn't know. She's actually doing really well around you guys. She's like curious.
Hey, you going home, baby? Yes.
The internet people are calling her Patty.
They're calling her Patty.
Oh, we're trying to get her to leave the couple.
You are beautiful. Where do you come from?
She was from originally the Columbus shelter, and then Soul Saver got her out. And she was, I guess,
okay,
she was
now
out
I know where
day.
I know you from.
Yeah.
Allison, right?
Allie.
Yes. It's been a long time. I did not make that connection yesterday. I knew you.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's all, you know. I just knew I knew you.
Yeah, she
He's
was
gonna get lots
on
of
her
these.
Last day, she was scheduled to be put down, and they found a foster and got her out, and then I guess she was at the foster for a long time, and I happened to see her at a downtown event, adoption event, and like at the time we had Jax, who just passed away, and I had him with me, and he just went up and sniffed her butt, and she didn't even turn around and look. Like, she was just so chill. And so,
she's gorgeous.
Yeah. And she's a mess. We had her DNA tested. She's a mess.
Is she?
Yeah.
You know.
And boxer.
I found the spot.
I'm reading a book on all of that, just genetic makeup of dogs, and they can be something that they absolutely don't look like.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. We had one that looked like a cattle dog several years back, and we DNA tested him, and he was a Rottweiler Doberman, but he had the wiry hair and the spots all over him.
Mm-hmm.
He was one of the. We had, when we got here, we had two different dogs and lost from both within like 2 years. Well, within 3 years, we lost both of them.
What do you think, baby?
Well, it's like my private home that got really old, you know. And they'll leave me last one. I got one that from the original kind of
It's like, because
and it really throws my grandbabies off, too, because, you know, it's a team.
How
old are they?
Five.
Oh,
yeah.
That must be really hard. It is, you know. So now
I
don't even tell them anymore.
Yeah.
They've
been on vacation, you know?
Yeah. All right, ready?
Yeah.
Can we get a leash for him?
I guess we can take one of those on the lawn.
Oh yeah.
He really likes her.
Do you want to grab it? I'll grab her and you can.
Okay.
All right, we're going home.
Oh, my purse. Can you grab my purse?
No, it was a while ago.
He is husband positive, but due to his age, we were afraid to do the fast kill on him, because it's really hard on him. So we've just been keeping him on husband positive. And I would suggest just to give him his heart on everybody, you know? Because he was once for me, so I mentioned that I was just talking to him.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
But
you
just
have
my
head. There you go. She's going
home.
Hi, sweet boy. Oh, he's so good.
Oh, he's so good. Usually over a year. Do you have to, like, what? Like, I know when they have heartworms and they're on treatment, you have to, like,
treat them.
He is
a real. Not really bad. I mean, he's gonna do up to his energy level, what he's comfortable doing, you know, and then he's gonna stop. But since it's not, we're not doing the fast kill on him, where you give the injection and it kills off the heartworms, because it's so hard. I mean, it's hard on a young dog, but it's so much stronger as an older dog. And then sometimes we lose them from the treatment.
Yeah.
So they, you know what I'm saying? So
we don't want to do that.
Yeah. So what we're doing is we're not talking to everyone. I mean, each veterinarian, we use veterinarian. Every vet has a different opinion about the fast pill or the heart pill. You would be going to, you know, so let you do that first. But if you have them positive thoughts, we do take care of them. We usually do that. But we cover the actual treatment, not anything. If Dr. LaFrank says he wants to do blood work and all this,
yeah,
he wouldn't
yeah
be able to cover all that.
Yeah.
That would be up to you to do that.
Okay.
I just want you to walk in, you know, I slide
open,
but not that you gonna.
Well, my main concern is that she had heartworm before we got her.
But you have her on preventative.
We have her on preventative, but, like, I just don't want to take any of
And what happens is, you know, while he is unpreventative, what the preventative does is it goes into the and that's what the mosquito gets out. You know, it's a little
it's just regular heart care.
And we sell it to the
team. Okay.
So a lot cheaper than a regular.
Okay. Cool. And do you also have like dewormer or dewormer and cat or either? Because I always
have an increase.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So we just do our regular like after.
You're going to get all of that. Get your
okay
receiver and everything
okay
is done.
Great.
You're going to get all of that.
Okay. Great. And what about dewormers? Because we always, like, it seems like every time we adopt a dog, even if they've been in rescue, they always end up having
worms. Well, we can deworm them, but we have everything here.
Okay.
We do just about everything.
Okay.
In-house.
Except we're not allowed to do it, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can do that.
No problem. When we got her, she had, like, diarrhea, and we were told, like, she's had everything done, So it wasn't until, like, maybe 2 weeks later when we're like, why is she hungry all the time?
Kathy, are you going home, man? I'm so happy for you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so happy for you.
You
know,
it's
really
not.
They're all looking more.
Yeah.
It's cool. I mean, you have a heart guard or whatever.
Yeah.
Three. That keeps the
pressure
on your stomach. If you have some
right?
They're eating. They will have worms.
Right.
Whether they're in a shelter or in someone's house, that just happens.
Right.
Because they can go outside and drink out of cat food. And drink out of food.
Yeah. Right.
These guys snuggling.
And the worms come about really fast, you know? A dog can swallow a bean and then have pink worms for 3 days.
Right.
So keeping them on that heart guard keeps everything in shape. And all the intestinals. You know, and before we did all this, I never understood why our dogs don't have worms.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But it's because it's all in the
okay.
So yeah, have to come over here.
Okay.
Yeah, I have to get this bill on.
Gotta do the paperwork to make it official.
And I used to get a whole business at you. Yeah.
No. We'll be outside soon.
Look at you. You look comfortable. You look quite comfortable.
Okay. Oh, I'll be right back.
Help us maintain a no-kill Columbus.
And do you prefer like a check or credit card?
A good shelter.
That's funny, I never used checks when I brought it.
I'll print out this sheet for them.
And can you add the city permit?
Yep, she's gonna be her new brother. He is. You ready to go?
Jill, can you come back here? Baby's trying to follow her.
Yeah, we gotta wait for some paperwork. Bye bye. Bye, thanks for watching.
Okay.
Okay.
I thought you had a dress on groovy.
No, bro, it's your baby.
Well,
I
did.
Hello.
Okay,
no, no, I don't have any.
They got some, but they haven't contacted anybody yet.
She brought me 12 yesterday.
Oh, I know.
Sorry. Hi, it's okay.
Yeah. I was wondering if I could get a receipt for this stuff.
Of course.
Yeah, I'm saying they have to have it for this.
They seem like some practicals.
Yes.
She's just not wagging because all these people.
But are they
I think so.
Oh, there's baby jar, baby food in there too.
Okay.
Jars. Thank you, ma'am.
All right. Thank you,
Mr. All right.
Have fun. Have you tried to catch the kitty?
We haven't tried, but she's coming on the porch. She's just not going in the trap. She's got to be smart.
Yeah. Do you want her to bring the bedroom?
Maybe if we change the trap, she'll
change
think, okay,
trap.
It's not a trap.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And sometimes if you cover it, but leave both
ends
open,
we
did that.
Yeah.
Shoot.
But I'm leaving.
Oh, okay.
And I will be back until next week.
Oh, okay.
So we'll try again next week then.
Okay.
And I'll bring your trap back.
Okay. All right. Whenever, just text me and let me know when you're going to bring it, and I'll bring the other one, or
okay.
When you get back, and I'll bring it.
If they catch her while I'm away, I'll tell my husband and he can take her up there.
Okay, because you said the neighbor or something.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Because she's not coming near my house.
Yeah.
So.
And that may be it. Yeah.
And I'll message you and let you know if
they
catch her.
Okay.
That way. All right.
Okay. I'll go by pause. Okay. All right.
Thank
well, good
you.
Luck. Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll see you later.
Yeah.
All righty.
Why are you still here? Oh. I haven't touched
any other
keys. That'll be later this afternoon.
Let me come see you. Let me come see the baby. Okay.
Is it okay if I
do? Oh, yeah.
I've got two senior dogs. Yes, I do. Yes, I do have two senior dogs. You're very sweet. You're very sweet. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Did you take him in the back?
No.
Nope. Then you haven't had it.
Okay.
Okay. We are live in Columbus, Georgia, witnessing a dog currently known as Scruffy going for the first time ever to his forever home. How about you crack the window and sound? He's putting his head out. Thank you. whole new world to him. Sniffing the air. And this is his sister here, baby. She's been with us for several years, 3 years now. Facebook moved to save him, but then when he got saved, and like went to the shelter, boy, he really likes going out there, doesn't he?
Yeah, is he okay?
Yeah.
He's not out too far?
No, he really likes to go for it. Anyway, when he went to the shelter, everybody didn't pay attention to him, and the shelter that he was at was a kill shelter. So he was about to be put down, and then a no-kill rescue saved him, and they've had him for the last 6 months in the kennel. And our dog passed away 2 weeks ago, just 2 weeks ago tomorrow, and I convinced my wife that we should adopt. We started looking, and I saw this guy on the online, the picture of him, and I was just like, that is a nice, neat-looking dog. And we went there yesterday and saw him and just fell in love immediately. We were like, let's give that old guy a home. Supposedly he's 6 years old, so he's got a good... going to have a good long run with us, and we are really good dog parents. We give really good treats, belly rubs, trips to mountains, trips to beaches. So, and then this little girl here, she's a little bit of a scaredy dog. She's got a giant tongue that drools. Oh yeah, we just picked him up from a real high-end dog spa called Dramatic Paws, P-A-W-S. It's a pun for dog paws. And he got the rosemary rub bath. He was filthy when we got him. His hair was all clumped up, and now he's got nice hair that blows in the breeze. The dogs seem to get along really well. Seen and smelled more today than he has for the last 6 months. Better get yourself back there. We're now approximately 6 blocks away from home. 6.5. He's gonna be eating holistic canned dog food. He's gonna eat bully sticks, just like this girl does. window rider. His name right now is Scruffy, but we got several names that we're thinking of. If you're listening, you might want to vote. One name is P-Bay, which is a foreign Spanish name. Another name is Morbi, which is named after one of our favorite singers. And then the name that I really like is Scritch, because he likes to be scritched and he kind of looks like a scritch. Well, we might keep Scruffy, I don't know, it's just kind of an obvious name. Oh, somebody's voting. Oh, we got one vote for Morby, one vote for Scratch. Okay, we're just a block or so away from home. This is the moment. He's never going to have to sleep in a cage again. Okay, this is where you live, my friend. She can go without a leash. Come on, buddy. This is it.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby. There you go.
There you go. Make your mark. This is it. You're going to walk up those stairs a whole bunch of times. Here you go.
Oh, watch out for the cat. Oh, I guess they don't know where to
go. He is home. Look around.
You want to go outside, baby? Baby, you want to go outside?
You want to see the backyard? Here, let's take this out here.
Baby, you
want to
go outside?
You guys want
to
go outside?
Out we go. Out we go.
Come here, buddy.
Look.
Come on.
Check out your yard.
And he'll be an indoor dog. We're not going to leave him out here. Oh, and also there are these antique metal shingles if any of you want to buy them. They're for sale. We got thousands of them. All right. Well, thank you all for joining us. Here's to a nice long life for the dog tentatively named Scruffy.